Hello, welcome to MCN. This is Cadwell Park, and that is Chris Walker's 2000 GSX-R 750 BSB bike. 19 years ago, me and my friends went up and down the country, Brands Hatch, Alton Park, and of course Donington for that famous final round, to watch Walker versus Hodgson. There have been some big battles in BSB, but that's probably the biggest. And now, 19 years later, we're here at Cadwell to ride that very bike. Cannot wait. So that's six frantic laps on Chris Walker's 2000 GSX-R 750 BSB bike. What a machine. We talk now about bikes being quick steering, but the way that thing goes from there to there is unbelievable. It just wants to be on its side. I'm a lot bigger than Chris, and the seat unit on the bike's really close to the tank. And so you end up sitting, feeling squashed up. So when you get to a corner, you naturally shift your bum off and you adopt these kind of almost contorted body positions, which make you feel exactly how he looked on the bike. When you look back at footage from that 2000 season, he's climbing all over it, and the bike makes you feel how he looked. And with the close ratio gearbox and the engine's appetite for revs, the orange taco needle was constantly vertical. There's barely any change in revs as you're going through the gears. And when you're tucked in behind the screen down the back straight, it's like being in the telly with the onboard footage that we all used to watch. Sensational. Initially, at the end of the back straight, didn't feel like the brakes were very good. So first couple of laps, finding my feet, a bit worried, I'm not sure about this. And then you give it a good squeeze, and there's so much braking power, so much power. And then it turns so easily, so easily. You end up turning too much. I keep sitting the bike up in a long corner because it's so keen to turn that you find you're going to end up on the grass on the inside of the corner. It's a remarkable, remarkable thing. So we've also got John Crawford's GSX-R here as well from the same season. So it's the sister bike to the Walker bike. So same engine, same specification. Feels completely different. Sits a lot more level. It's still agile, it's still nimble, still obviously handles really well. It's a factory supported race bike, but it hasn't got the same up on its toes delicacy that the Walker bike's got. It feels more set up towards stability than agility. Well, that's the thing that really stands out with the Walker bike, is that it's up over the front and it wants to turn. So that final round of BSB in 2000, when Walker's bike malfunctioned and left all the smoke around Donington Park, me and my friends had ridden there on our own GSX-Rs. We were Walker fans, we'd got S-Rads, it was all about the GSX-R. And that bike feels how I wanted a race GSX-R to feel. So my road bike had got the fat tank and the wide clip-ons and the compact riding position, but you imagined that the race bike would be taller and steeper and even more eager to turn, and that it would rev harder and it would pull harder and wheelie in second gear out of corners. And all those things are true. It's exactly how you'd imagine it to be, how you'd want it to be. It shows how much sports bikes have changed in the last 10, 15, 20 years. We ride bikes now and we lean our shoulders in, and it's all about moving your upper body. And you ride that and you want to stick your bum out and stay hunched in over the bike. It makes you ride in a very different way, and it feels very different to a modern sports bike in terms of space and how it reacts to your inputs. So it's the old don't meet your heroes cliche, but I'm glad I did, because that's a massive thing ticked off the must-do list. That's Chris Walker's bike, and I've ridden it, and it's sensational. Thank you ever so much for watching. Remember to like and subscribe.